This is my office, it's my bedroom, it's everything. I mean, I spend more time in this vehicle than I do in my own apartment.
Ryan Cook has been a location scout in Boston for the past 10 years. In that time, he's worked on films like Ted, Black Mass, and Stronger.
One of the things that's great about Boston and the greater Boston area is like how historic it is, and the fact that it is such an old city and an old area. You film in places like LA, everything's not that old, and it sort of all feels the same. Boston has character. For a lot of directors nowadays, they don't want to film on sound stages. They don't want to film on sets. They want to film in real locations. You want to find places that feel unique and feel like they have an authenticity to them. And that not only is because of what you want to come across on screen and in how things look, but also for the director and for the actors, their performances and their storytelling is enhanced by being in the real location versus being on a soundstage.
Ryan went to Emerson College where he studied film. He got his first experience on a set during his junior year.
I just started going up to film sets and started calling people and was like, I'll work 24 hours a day, I'll do whatever, I'll pick up trash.
What was your first, I guess, big break, your first big location that you scouted?
So the first location I scouted that actually like ended up in the show was like for a movie nobody's ever seen. It's like an Italian movie. They shot it here, and it was like basically like Sex in the City, but with men for Italian television.
When he was 21, he got his first job on a major Hollywood motion picture, Night and Day, starring Tom Cruise and Cameron Diaz.
Maybe I didn't make it clear enough, but we're gonna have to stick together for a little bit because of our, you know, our situation.
Everybody get down. Get back, get back.
Much of the movie was filmed in and around Boston, and one of Ryan's jobs was to find the perfect home, then convince the owners to allow an entire film crew inside.
I found we were looking for, you know, some houses, and houses are difficult because it's like you gotta have the right look and the inside and the outside, and we were looking for this like Tom Cruise's parents' house in the show, and I must have scouted 60 houses. And I went in and was sitting down with the homeowners and started negotiating the deal as we were moving their furniture out of the house to start dressing the place, because we had to get it ready. We're gonna film the next week. And that's where I really sort of really fell in love with it, because I was like, this is exhilarating.
When you're walking around town, are you always thinking, like, what could this be? How could this be used in a movie? Or, I mean, do you look at Boston in a different way than most
Absolutely.
People?
Yeah, becoming a location scout and a location manager, you develop a really intimate relationship with the city.
No, we're actually down like where we filmed Ted's apartment.
While finding locations is his primary focus, his job requires him to get permission before filming can begin, which takes some finesse.
Peter was the one that I had to convince that to allow us to film here. And I don't think it was until like the second or third day of actually being here that he was like, oh, all right, this guy actually knows what he's doing.
And then some. Yeah.
You have to sort of massage it and get people to understand this is unique, this is out of the box, but it's gonna be okay. We're gonna come in, we're gonna do what we want, and in 2 days from now, you're gonna never know we're here. And ultimately, you're gonna get to see your city or your town, you know, sort of up on the big screen or on television.
I would imagine a lot of people aren't too thrilled when you say like, hey, we're gonna have to shut down this road and people aren't gonna be allowed in this area of town for this long.
Yeah, you get a mix of it, right? So it's like sort of like the circus coming to town. Some people get excited by the circus coming to town, but after a couple days, they're like, all right, we're sort of sick of the circus.
In 2013, the circus came back to town, and Ryan was hired as the location scout for Ted, starring Mark Wahlberg.
What? Excuse me?
I want it.
Hey, I'm not an it, pal. I'm a he, all right?
I'm sorry, little guy, but my bear isn't for sale. See, I've had him since I was about your age. He's very, very special to me.
One of the opening scenes in Ted is Mark Wahlberg's character works at like sort of enterprise, like car rental dealership. And we were looking for that location. They wanted something that was in the city. I went to Emerson College and I used to live right over here on Cortez Street. And this was a Tedeschi's, like a convenience store. And it had a little Dunkin' Donuts inside. So every day on my way to class, I would stop in, get a Dunkin' Donuts and go to class. And then eventually that Tedeschi's closed down, so it was just an empty storefront. So a couple years later, as we're making Ted, I sort of remembered this location. Basically, Ted drives in the lot, he scrapes a car in here, and then drives out, and then almost hits a car going out, you know, in the traffic this way. And so this was our world.
That's my bad, I was sending a tweet.
couple years later, it's now a veterinary clinic, and you could bring your dog or your cat here and never know that this is where Mark Wahlberg and a pot-smoking teddy bear came and sort of had this iconic opening of the movie to introduce these characters.
Ted was filmed in various areas all over the city, including Chelsea and East Boston.
So here's Compare Supermarket. We filmed Ted here. This is in Ted 1. This is the grocery store that Ted worked at. And this is where he worked at the front register.
Thank you very much. Please come again. We have a lot more groceries.
But one of the most memorable scenes, the ending, took place at Fenway Park.
So the end of the movie takes place at Fenway, and it's a high, iconic scene where they're they're climbing the tower here, and Ted gets ripped in half, and he falls down onto the field here.
You're mine, Ted!
Screw you, pal. I belong to John Bennett.
For us that worked on the movie and for everybody who's seen it, you really sort of can't imagine another way. But originally, the ending was supposed to be at a different location. It wasn't written for Fenway.
For a number of reasons, the other locations fell through, so Ryan recommended the historic ballpark.
Everybody started giving pitches, and one of the things that I sort of put out there was, Fenway has this ladder on the Green Monster. I thought, wouldn't it be cool if Ted, climbs the ladder? So we're here, this is, Exeter Street in Boylston. The marathon finish line is right down here.
In 2016, Ryan was hired as the location scout for Stronger, starring Jake Gyllenhaal as marathon bombing survivor Jeff Bowman.
I'm gonna be there at the finish line for you.
I'm gonna make a big sign for you.
Doesn't show up for anything. And then he shows up.
Bowman became the face of Boston Strong after this photo was taken of him moments after the blasts. Stronger tells his story before and after he lost his legs in the attack.
We had to figure out how we're going to recreate, this moment where Jake Gyllenhaal, playing Jeff Bowman, comes out of the alleyway here, comes down Exeter Street, and he's trying to find a place at the finish line to cheer on Aaron and cheer on his girlfriend.
For some of the scenes, hundreds of extras had to be brought in to recreate the 2013 marathon. And for that, Ryan had to shut down Boylston Street, one of the busiest streets in the city.
We had a vendor come in and set up barricades all down here and put the flags in place and sort of recreate this sort of mini section of the marathon finish line. We can't close down the Boylston Street sidewalk, so we had the public intermixing with all of our extras and the cameras just floating in and out. We did actually film on Marathon Day in 2016. We got some access to get the wider shots, the stuff that you really can't recreate.
As you can imagine, the movie presented some challenges for the crew given the sensitive subject matter.
When you're making a movie like Stronger that has to do with real characters at a real event, especially 3 years after the events of 2013, we were filming in 2016, it's very fresh in everybody's mind, and it's very fresh in the city. Everybody's gonna be very watchful of you and what you're doing, and you wanna be sensitive to that.
When it came time to recreate the bombs going off and the aftermath, those scenes were filmed off-site.
Or, the other scenes of the actual bombing and the aftermath of what happened to Jeff, we recreated part of Boylston Street on a soundstage.
In the weeks and months after the bombing, the Red Sox became a source of inspiration for a city rocked by terror.
This is our city. And nobody gonna dictate our freedom. Stay strong.
Some of the more powerful scenes from Stronger took place during a game at Fenway.
Certain moments of Jeff's story that we wanted to recreate, and him throwing out the first pitch at Fenway was really important to us, not only for his character and his story, but sort of encapsulating what he meant to the city of Boston. One of my favorite moments in the movie is after he throws out the pitch, first pitch, and he's sort of, going, beneath the seats and going through some of the crowd, and people are coming up to him, and he has this moment of realization of, he's been fighting this whole time,
you know, being called a hero, and he doesn't like that.
What's going on?
Just give me a second here. I just want to talk to him for a second.
Can I help you with?
My kid brother, he was in the Marines, over in the war. About 5 years ago, he got hit with an IED. He's gone, man. You know, but seeing you out there today throwing that fucking pitch, you showed the world that they can't fucking break us no matter what the hell they do. You know, it gave me a little hope, made me feel a little better, and I just want to say fucking thank you for that, man. That's all.
And he finally has this moment of, like, I see what my story is doing and how it's helping people and how people can relate to it.
It's gonna be all right. I'm gonna be okay, right? So you're gonna be okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Before filming at Fenway, Ryan had to make sure everything at the historic ballpark looked just as it did 3 years before.
We had to take down the 2013 championship banners. Obviously, we won the World Series that year. So everywhere we go, whenever there was reference to that, we had to make sure that we covered that up. Because people will point it out when they see the movie. You normally, when you say a period piece, like Black Mass is a period piece. It took place in the 70s and the 80s. But for Stronger, it's also a period piece, and people don't necessarily realize that. We're here at the shipyard in Chelsea, and this is one of the main locations for Black Mass. It's one of my favorite places because you have the city, but you also have the greediness, and it has character. And that's always what we're looking for.
One of the darker films Ryan has worked on was Black Mass, starring Johnny Depp as notorious Boston mob boss Whitey Bulger, a film about real criminals and real events.
We are telling a story about people that are still alive, people that still exist. Wounds that are still very raw, even though it's, you know, only 20 years later, you go in a selfie, everybody's got a story, and you're telling, and so you have to be sensitive to that nature.
Why'd they kill Tommy?
I think Jim was convinced that Tommy ratted out Mickey to Angelo.
And you're meeting some of the real characters that existed, and like you're reading the script, and you're just like, oh, these are characters, and then all of a sudden you like run into somebody from the Angelo family, and you're like, oh yeah, this is really close to home.
Right, that's enough.
It's Kevin, right? Meet Joey Angelo.
Bulger was the brother of a state senator and the most infamous criminal in South Boston. Black Mass tells the story of how he rose to power in Boston's underworld, all while working with FBI agent John Connolly to take down his rivals.
It ain't Rand, Jimmy. It's an alliance.
An alliance between me and the FBI.
No, between you and me.
This location is a historic location. It's really gritty, and it played a major sort of character and a major role in the film. It's sort of the meeting spot for Whitey Bulger's character and John Connolly, and we filmed a couple different scenes here. One was just right where we're standing with the city here, sort of. You have the McArdle Bridge, and then you have this brutal-esque building, and then you have the city in the background. Of course, you know, further over here, you have the Tobin.
The movie takes place in the 1970s, which presented the production crew with various challenges since the city has changed significantly over the years.
And with the city in the background, it looks gorgeous, but you obviously have to digitally erase some of the buildings that weren't there at that time. There's buildings that are here that weren't there in the 1970s, so obviously in post-production, we had to get rid of those. When you're making something that's a period piece, that's 1970s, right? 1974, 75, everywhere you look has to be period. Not only the skyline, like I mentioned earlier, but even on the bridge itself, we did intermittent closing of traffic on the bridge and had our own 1970s cars going back and forth across the bridge.
Getting the perfect shot sometimes requires a monumental effort. Here's what Ryan did to achieve a specific look for just one scene.
So one of the things that we had to do from a location standpoint is we wanted to move all the street lights that are on this side of the street, we wanted to move them to that side of the roads. Whitey sort of came in and joined John Connolly's character, and then we had this as our background, which is really cool. We have this old brick building, and it seems like a little sort of thing, a subtle thing within the film, but it was a big undertaking for us, and then of course we have to put them back afterwards.
For another scene, Ryan had to get creative, transforming one Massachusetts neighborhood into another.
In Black Mass, for instance, when we recreated the South Boston, like St. Patrick's Day Parade, we did that in Lynn.
because we can't shut down Broadway and Dorchester Street and Southie. Like, that's just logistically not possible.
A large part of Ryan's job is working with cities and towns that may be pretty wary of inviting hundreds of outsiders into their neighborhood.
The thing that I hate the most is when the local newspaper says Hollywood comes to town. 5% of the people out there are Hollywood. Yes, we may be an inconvenience, or like you may not love the idea of us filming here, but when you look out your window and you see 250 people out there, blue-collar workers like myself, sort of just busting our butt, those are all locals.
One of the added benefits of having a movie filmed in your town is the money.
It's a good revenue source. People don't understand, on Black Mass, we spent approximately $2.5 million in just my department alone. I'm one of 10 departments. We spend a lot of money because we don't own anything. Everything's rental, and then we're moving to locations every day. It's not a revenue source that everybody can rely on, but it's like a booster shot. You go in, like, I just spent $20,000 filming at a church for 2 days. Tell me that that church makes $20,000 in donations over the course of a month, 2 months, 6 months.
While getting local cities and towns some national exposure is part of Ryan's goal, he also wants to make sure he gets invited back when the cameras stop rolling.
We want to get Boston, we want to get Lawrence and Lowell and Quincy and Revere. We want to get these communities in Newton up and exposed to the rest of the country and the rest of the world and show them, look how great this place is where we live. So at the end of the day, going to set and picking up trash off the side of the sidewalk because you want to leave the place as cleaner than you found it so that you can come back again. And that is the part of the job that keeps you humble, but also it's like, there's nothing else I'd rather do in the world.